Hey guys, Krista of Real Life Captured here. Today I want to quickly go over a few of my favorite tricks and tools in Photoshop that will help you quickly and easily fix your photos. So many times you take a great photo, but then you look at it and you realize it's too dark, or the color is weird, or something in the background of the photo is just distracting or off. So today I'm going to show you a few super, super easy tricks in Photoshop that will help you make your photo amazing. First, let's make sure that you have a copy of Photoshop. If you don't have it already, click back to my blog post where I've linked to Photoshop CC. Photoshop used to cost $800, which made it so hard to purchase. But in recent years, Photoshop has made it super easy on us by lowering the price point to $9.99 for a monthly subscription. So going forward, I'm going to assume that you have Photoshop CC and you've opened your photo in that program. We're going to start right here with a picture of my sweet little son, and right away you'll notice that it is a little dark. It's a super cute picture. I love his little face. Of course, I'm partial, but the foreground, his face and everything, are just too dark. If you'll notice in the background is pretty bright, and if you had photographed this yourself with your camera on program mode, a lot of times the camera will evaluate the entire scene. It'll see this bright spot back here, and it will make the rest of the photo darker because of it. Now, I don't really care about this bright spot in the background. I don't really care if that's properly exposed or not, because what I was going for was I really wanted a cute picture of my son. So now he's too dark. How do we fix this? There's a super quick way to fix this. We're gonna go into Photoshop, into the Curves palette. And how you do that is if you're on a PC, you hit Control M, or if you're on a Mac, Command M, and that's gonna pop up your Curves palette right here. And this is very easy to use. All you have to do is pull up on the curve to make your photo brighter, or pull down on it to make your photo darker. As you can see, it has a very dramatic effect. So since he's a little too dark, I'm gonna pull up on this line until I make him bright. And this comes down to personal preference as far as how bright you like your photos. The one thing I will say to watch is watch your skin tones, because if you raise this too much, you'll see in just a minute, you see how this gets all blotchy and white? We call this blowing out the highlights. You don't want to make it so bright that you get white patchy marks on someone's skin, okay? So like right here, I'm starting to get some white splotchy marks right there. And when you go to print that, that will print horribly. So that's why you do not want to do that. It'll print all blotchy and everything. So let's lower it back down. And again, this comes down to personal preference, how the scene was. If it's dark and stormy and cloudy out, you might not want to brighten it as much. But in this occasion, it was bright and sunny out. And so I want to brighten it quite a bit and make sure that it looks like the actual scene, like when I was there. Okay. So that's all you have to do, and then you hit okay. If you wanna see before and after, you can just click right here to do preview, and it'll show you the before and after. But I think that in general looks pretty good, so I'm gonna hit okay. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is add some punch with adding some contrast. You can also do that in Curves. You just go to your Curves palette again by hitting Control M on a PC or Command M on a Mac, and we're gonna make what's called an S-curve, where you pull up at the top to make a bright, and then at the bottom, it's gonna go down to make this nice S-curve. Now you can see here that I made it a little too dramatic to where I'm getting some white blown out highlights right here, and this would probably be a little too much of an S-curve. So play around with this. I kind of like just a little bit of an S-curve in here, just to make it punch a little bit more, give it a little more contrast, and it'll print a little nicer. It won't be so flat. So again, you can hit preview here and see the before and after. Before, the tones are a little flat. I mean, they're super cute and fine, but they're a little flat. If I add a little bit of this S curve in here, it just adds a little more punch and contrast to the final photo. Okay, go ahead and hit okay. Now, if you want to go back in your history palette and just see your before and after, before the brightening and before the contrast, you go from there to there. And I think that for a few seconds of work, maybe a minute or so, that's a huge improvement. So that is my first tip and trick, is to use your Curves palette. My second favorite tip and trick is to use your color balance tool. So many times you take a photo, and especially if it's in the shade or if it's out in a green area, you're going to get a weird color cast. For instance, in this photo, we have a blue color cast. So to fix this, it's very easy. You're going to go into your color balance tool, which is accessed by hitting Control B or Command B on a Mac, Control B on a PC. Okay, so the easiest way to think about this is to look at what color is cast in this photo. In this instance, it's blue. And we're gonna pull away from that color. So you'll see right here, here's your blue, and we're just gonna pull away from it to add some yellow back in, and that will negate that blue cast, okay? Now you don't wanna add too much, so just use your eyes, kinda eyeball this, and see what you think looks like a good balance. You can also go up here for a blue cast, you see cyan right here, and pull to the red. And I like to just kind of balance this and play around with this until I feel like it looks like natural skin tones. So again, you can use your preview right here. And I think that skin tones look a lot more natural already just by doing that one little thing, pulling these away from the blue and the cyan. I'm gonna go ahead and hit okay. If I was going to continue to work on this photo, I would do what we did in the first step, and I would brighten it up by going to my curves palette and hitting Control M on a PC or Command M on a Mac. And I'm gonna pull up on my curves to make this a little brighter. I might pull down at the bottom just to give it a little bit of contrast, that S curve we talked about. And already, I mean, within seconds, I was sitting here explaining this to you, but that would have taken me all of about 20 seconds in reality. So this is your before, this is your after, and that's only two steps, doing color balance and then curves, before and after. Again, a huge dramatic improvement with just a few very, very simple steps. Okay guys, my third and final favorite tip and trick is to use the Spot Healing Brush in Photoshop. This tool can be accessed by going over here in your tools palette. And if you'll notice when you click on it, there are actually five tools that are located in this one tool. So when you go and click on it, make sure that you hover over it and go, I click and hold down or hover over it, and make sure that this top one is selected. It says Spot Healing Brush. The other way you can access it is by hitting J on your keyboard. Again, if something else pops up when you hit J, like let me exit out of that. I'll go to a different tool. I'm going to hit J. Now you'll notice this is not the Spot Healing Brush, okay? So even though I hit J, it didn't actually go to that. But I can hit J and then I can hover over here and again make sure that the Spot Healing Brush is actually selected. Okay, so what do you use this for? A lot of times in the background of your photo, there's something annoying or there's a stray hair or there's a random person way in the background or a car in the background and you just want it out of the photo. In this instance, we've got this weird little white strip and another one right here and I just want that out of the photo because I feel like it's distracting. I notice that right away and it just kind of bothers me. So I'm going to select that tool again, hitting J or going over here and highlighting that. And then using your bracket keys on your keyboard, you can make this tool bigger or you can make it smaller. I prefer to make the brush just a little bigger than the actual area. So I'm gonna make this about that size, maybe a little smaller. The other way you can access this is by going up here and you'll notice you have a size right here that you can make it bigger or smaller. But I prefer to use my shortcut keys because it just saves so much time when you're editing and you don't have to spend 5 minutes clicking around over here. So again, I'm gonna make it about the size of this and then all you have to do is click and drag and voila, it's gone. We're gonna do the same for this spot right here, just click and drag and it's gone. Isn't that amazing? It used to be a few years ago that you had to actually recreate the background with a clone stamp and a bunch of other stuff. And I just absolutely love, love, love this tool. You can use it for so much. If I wanted to take out, let's say, this little knot of wood right here, again, gone. It just makes things disappear. And it's such a great tool. I will say, Photoshop, the way this tool works is it looks at the things that are surrounding the area of what you're taking out, and based on its little algorithm, it will calculate what it should do. So if you use this tool in a very busy area of your photo, it may not work. It might come up with something really weird like that. And so it doesn't work in every instance, but in most instances it does. Let's switch to a different photo. Right here, you'll notice we have some weird blades of grass in the background. These aren't that big of a deal, but just to show you a little how it works in the background, I can take and just click and drag over those. It'll take those right out. We kind of have this weird blue pipe sticking up right here. I don't know if this will work or not right here because this is kind of a complicated background right there. Let's see what it does. And that worked pretty well. This also can work great on large things in the photo depending on what's around it. Let's click back and you'll notice here my big old foot is in the photo, and obviously that's super distracting. I do not want that in there. So I'm gonna make my brush larger by using my right bracket key, which is located above the enter key on your keyboard. Or again, you can go up here and use the size slider to make your brush bigger. So I'm gonna make my brush a little bigger, and then all I'm gonna do is click and drag, and let's see what it does. It's gonna think about it a minute. Perfect, that's really close. Well, not perfect, but it's pretty close to being perfect. Let's zoom in and see what it did here. Okay, so we have a little bit of weirdness here and a little bit of weirdness here. So I'm gonna make my brush a little smaller and I'm just gonna try again. And I'm gonna keep doing this until I feel like the photo is perfect. And so I do that a couple times and that looks really, really, really good. So we're just gonna stop right there. And you notice how easy and quick that was. That only took a few seconds to click and drag that and, you know, touch a couple little spots up and it was done. Isn't that amazing? So guys, that is a roundup of my top three tips and tricks that will quickly and super, super easily transform your photos. Again, if you don't have Photoshop, be sure to go pick it up. It's only $9 a month. You can cancel it whenever you want. And these tools will dramatically help you improve your photos. All right, guys, hope that helped. If you have any questions, please comment below or hop back to the website and comment on the blog, and I'll do my best to answer your questions. Also, if this video was helpful, please subscribe or give us a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to our newsletter by going to the website and subscribing there so you can make sure you don't miss any lessons. Thanks a lot, guys.